Welcome to Learnpedia, the ultimate JEE and NEET prep tool that is currently being used by over 20,000 aspirants. Now let's see if you can answer this actual JEE question. If you think you got the answer, post it in the comment section below. To understand the concept behind this question, go ahead and watch this video.
So let us discuss Kepler's third law. That is law of periods. This law states that the square of the time for the planet to complete a revolution about the sun is proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis of the elliptical orbit. Now suppose this orbit is an elliptical orbit and a planet of mass M is revolving around the sun of mass capital M. Then since planet is rotating in a circle, we can say that gravitational force is responsible for the body to move in a circle. Here, gravitational force is responsible for the body to move in a circle. Therefore, this acts as a centripetal force, or we can write it as centripetal force equals to gravitational force, or mv square by r should be exactly equals to g times capital M small m by r square. Or solving it to be further, we can write v square equals to g m by r. Now according to the law, we have to calculate the time. So let us now look at the time period for a body to complete one revolution around the sun. We can easily say that the time period will be given as, time period T will be given as the total distance covered it upon speed of the satellite. So this implies that T equals to total distance covered it, that is 2 pi r, the total circumference, upon the speed of the satellite, that is v here. This implies that T square equals to 4 pi square r square upon v square, or this can be further written as T square equals to 4 pi square r square upon value of v square, which is just calculated above, to be g m by r, or it can be written as further 4 pi square r cube upon g m. So from this expression we can say that T square is directly proportional to r cube. This is Kepler's third law. So now we have calculated the square of time, which is directly proportional to cube of the semi-major axis.
Hey there, hope you understood the concept. Here's the solution to the question asked at the beginning. Found this video useful? Hit the like and share icons to enjoy more such videos. Use the comment section below to post your feedback, queries or questions. Learnpedia's JEE and NEET prep tools contain over 4,000 videos and over 20,000 questions. They are accessible online on our website and also offline through an SD card or a pen drive. To buy now, visit www.learnpedia.in. You can also try a free demo of a product before purchase.